In the past, we've already made videos where we covered how to mount a pelter or sword in headband headset onto a ballistic or bump helmet. Due to this, the question has risen on how to wear these kind of headsets underneath a helmet without mounting them. And that is exactly what we will cover here in this video. If you want to support us, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button to stay notified of our upcoming videos. Also, go visit shop.ReconBrothers.com for your quality tactical equipment. Now, before I'm going to explain what you need to do to wear one of these under your helmet, we first want to cover the pros and cons a bit regarding a mounted versus an under the helmet setup. Let's begin with one of the most important ones, and that is comfort. If we look at wearing these things for long periods of time, we can definitely say that a mounted setup is most comfortable. This because you don't have that continuous pressure of the headband on your head. Also, most helmet mounted setups allow you to simply rotate the ear cups to the back of the helmet and this way give your ear some airflow to cool down and get released from the pressure of the ear cups. This is obviously not possible with an under the helmet system. Next up is the ease of use with or without a helmet, and when it comes to this, the under the helmet setup is by far the easiest one. Just remove your helmet and you keep all the benefits of your headset. As for a mounted version, it's not that easy. It takes time to remove a mounted headset and some even require you to use tools to go back to a bridge or vice versa. Some systems are rather quick to change while others don't even allow it anymore. So if you intend to do this, make sure you are aware of what you get. In regards to your comms, you will obviously need to keep wearing your headset. Only difference is that the under the helmet version allows you to do that without wearing your helmet. Besides this, you can also look at the price, and here the under the helmet setup is overall cheaper. This because a mounted version usually requires you to cut the leather headband, get adapters for your specific helmet and the headset system, and if you want to use the bridge again, you will also need a replacement headband wrap. Also, when getting a helmet with a different rail type, you mostly need to get a different adapter as well. At last, you can also consider the ease and speed of putting everything on or off. And here the helmet mounted setup is by far the easiest one. Simply put your brain bucket on, press those cups over your ears, adjust where needed, and you're ready to go. As for the under the helmet setup, it is possible but not that practical. And how you do that is exactly what we're going to show you in a moment. There are, however, also a few things you need to be aware of before being able to wear a headset underneath your helmet. One is the fact that you can only do this with slim headband designs. Otherwise, there is no way it will fit, and if it does, you probably won't last very long that way. These slim headband designs are usually made of leather, but it's possible you'll find fabric or rubber versions these days as well. Also, a good thing to know is that it is very inconvenient to get a headset with two down leads underneath a helmet unless your wires allow to be plugged in or out. Above this, before you're going to start, you want to set the size of both the headset and the helmet separately first. This way the headset won't need any more adjustments once you have everything on, and the helmet should only require minor adjustments in the worst case. Just so you know up front, you want the bridge of your headset to be at the level of your ears, so really on the top of your head, not towards the back. Also, there shouldn't be any sort of gap between your head and the bridge. So that being said, let's give you the steps on how to successfully wear your helmet over your headset. As for the first step, you are going to get your helmet and remove or adjust some of the inside padding. Here you want to take out the pads on the left and the right side where the headband will come. You also want to either remove or relocate the center top pad such that it fits comfortably with the headband. This may require some trial and error. Important is to only make adjustments to the padding and not the liner system, because that's what protects your head together with the shell. Next, make sure the retention system of your helmet is fully disengaged. Put your headset on and, as said before, make sure to wear it properly. Now comes the part where a headset becomes difficult in comparison to regular ear pro without a microphone and down lead. Here you first want to bring your helmet close to your face and get your mic and wire through the gap of the retention system. Once that's done, you're going to bring the helmet closer to your head and place the retention straps aside the ear cup against your face. After that, you can bring the helmet over your head and put the other straps aside the other ear cup against your face and close the retention system. Tighten your helmet on the back and adjust the retention straps where needed. And that is basically it, guys. Nothing more special about it. And if you want to remove the helmet, you simply have to work in the opposite way. Hope this video helped you out. If it did, make sure to leave a like. Go have a look at our headset and helmet offerings and much more through shop.ReconBrothers.com. Thanks for watching, and you'll see us next time.